Hey guys, I'm going to cast round one between the Marvelous from Wong Kwan and Eric Wong. Of course, it's in the Master Bug Chatterment. So, Bugchi vs. Lucids. I think this is the favorite matchup from the tournament. So many Bugchi vs. Lucids matchups. And this matchup is weird because basically Bugchi can wreck Seleucid's cavalry, and Bugchi is more maneuverable and can kite easily, but Seleucid has something that Bugchi is struggling against, and that's shield bearers. It's so hard to beat the shield bearers. And the Bugchian build is not very good. Well, the Seleucid's build is kind of alright, but I still don't like it. Only one shield bearer. Four Tauro Spears, why do you need Tauro Spears? Maybe for Jarn Voris against Bugchi and Oakhurst, but this guy's got 95 farmer. What are you going to achieve with Tauro Spears? Just wasting ammunition. But 5 median cavalry, nice. Too many Tauro Spears, I think. 3 Snowslingers, 1 Persian Hoplite, and 5 Torque Swords. Shoot better gem. And by the way, if you guys are wondering, I changed the language of the game to English because some asked me and told me that they can't understand anything, so I'm back to English. And let's see, Bugchi. 3 Bugchi human, 1 Easter Spearman, 3 Persian light archers, some Torque Swords, some Scale Torque Hoplite, and some Levy Pikes with Bugchi and Rogard. And this is going to be tough for Bugchi. The Marvelous is a Shogun 2 player, so he doesn't really know the mechanics or runes of round 2. So this means to be even harder. So Persian light archers are going to try to probably skirmish with the Eastern Singers. This is terrible, terrible mistake, because the Eastern Singers got that little shield that gives them like 25 miss chance. So yeah, the archers are going to miss, well, not really miss chance, but box chance. So with the support of the Bugchi and Oakhurst, the media carry got a quick charge and then they're going to retreat, but I don't think it's really worth it. Let's see the archers. Yeah, look at the archers, they're getting wrecked. And they're even protected kinda by the Bugchi human. The Eastern Spearmen are going to try to stall the Tauro Spears, but Tauro Spears don't really need to waste Jeremy Volleys, they just need to charge, and Median Cavalry can wreck this unit really quick. Bugchi Human and Scale Tauro Hoplite are trying to protect the flank, and Seleucid will back off. And I don't really know how Dutch are beating the Singers. Now back to advance. Nice charge with the Bugchi and Nova Horse. The Torque Swords are going to get the... No, actually they didn't get the Jeremy Volley. Yeah, that was really weird. The Levy Pikes are trying to advance, but yeah, that's not really how you use pikes, you don't click an attack order. My Jarring Volley is there. And let's see, the Eastern Slingers are getting massacred by the archers, which is really weird. The Buck Channel Horse need to do like this and not frontal charge. I don't really know why he's frontal charging and not taking the time and recharging. Yeah, Median Cavalry are getting wrecked. This Median Cavalry managed to get through the gap and are probably going to recharge. The Torx Swords engage the Pikes, which was weird, and the Levy Pikes got 8 kills. But Median Cavalry, yeah, look at the waste of cavalry over here. Not very good move. Yes, Commander. The archers are chasing away a shattered unit of Median cavalry. This is really, really bad. They're getting dangerously close to the Seleucid lines. Please, please retreat, mate. Okay. Oh, thanks. So Median cavalry is going to retreat. And really passive on that side. Another attempt to flank the Bactrians, but Seleucids have a lot weaker cavalry, and Seleucid players should have used the cavalry defensively and not that offensively. This is not a very good move. And 1 second, I need to turn off Discord because somebody is spamming. Okay, done. And let's see. So Torx Swords are in big trouble. They're going to die so fast to the shield bearers. These Torx Swords are dying. Whoa, red morale already. All the three Persian light archers are alive. And the three slingers are alive as well. This is weird. More Seleucid infantry incoming. This is really, really weird battle. The Buck Channel Horse are engaged by Torx Spears. Torx Swords are dying. But no Hoplite Phalanx from the Shield Bears. And I think their information attack, which is terrible, terrible mistake. And another mistake is letting the Median Cavalry to fight Torx Swords and not protecting the Slingers. So, yeah, Buck Channels are going to just charge the Slingers. And that's maybe the nail in the coffin for Seleucids. Because I don't see how Seleucids can do this. Orders understood. God Pinkish! For glory! To arms! Find your test, Commander! Yeah, Buck Channel Horse are just going to wreck the Slingers, and then they can wreck the Median Cavalry. Continue through to the Eastern Slingers, and then these Eastern Slingers. Then Buck Channel Horse can just recharge everything, and it should be pretty easy to do it. So cavalry charge, getting a nice quick charge, but the Torx Swords are in full HP, so there won't be huge amount of damage. Nice flank shots on the Torx Swords, but I think this is a waste. They're going to die anyways, and this is a far better target, because Bakhtian Rogar, yeah, it's like he was reading my mind. And pikes are not in pike flanks, which is not very good for Bakhtian. But now the Buck Channel Horse, yeah, they can just recharge the general. Even though Shield Bears are a beast of a unit, they'll just get wrecked. And let's see over here. So Toro Spears getting ranked by Cav, but the Cav needs to retreat. And Torque Swords getting shot at. Yeah, this is over. This is definitely over. Costly victory. Oh, actually, Bakchi was very Kong, sorry. best commenter. But, this build is more like versus elephant builds. And yeah, my build for Seleucids was just 4 pikes, 3, I think 3 shield bearers, some median car, I think 4 of them, 2 singers and some torque swords. But it is really hard to do this with it's really hard to win with this build versus Bakchi, because Bakchi just has better recovery, and you need to have you need to have better units in some other area, and shield bearers are such units, they're just going to destroy the torque sword, they're going to destroy the scale torque hopeless, and most likely going to destroy the Bakchi rogue guard. And in late game, they can just charge against the Bakchi and Old Horse, and if the shield bearers are full HP, the Bakchi and Old Horse are just going to die. But we'll play it. And let's see a second game. So, second game, Pergamon versus Bakchi. Interestingly, that Pergamon is not really using the buffs. Pergamon can bring 5 max aim and 4 horse archers. Horse archers don't really help Pergamon, but 5 max aim is really, really helpful. You can bring 5 Galatian swords, you can bring 5 Hopte, or if you want, you can bring 5 Hippias. And I don't really agree with the Pergamon build. I mean, it's an alright build, but I wouldn't pick it. Galatian Spears might be useful with their recovery counter tactics, but who would waste Bakchi and Old Horde by charging them into a recovery counter tactic unit? And yeah, let's see how this will go. The Marvelous got 3 Eastern Slingers, he got some Eastern Spearmen, some Torque Swords, some Bakchi and Rogue Guards, some Scale Torque Swords, some more Torque Swords, Scale Torque Swords, and a lot of Bakchi and Old Horse. So if he's careful with the cover and not using super offensive jealous in last battle, it shouldn't be really hard to do it. And Eastern Slingers firing at normal Slingers, this is terrible engagement for Pergamon. Pergamon should just rush. But is Pergamon just on the skirmishing agent? Yeah, just one loss to the Eastern Slingers, and these Slingers lost 30. So yeah, very good. Too aggressively with the Hippias answers, I think. But they still got the charge. Too weird that the Marvelous allowed the Hippias answers to get a charge. Let's see, the Galatian swords and the Hoplite gauged, but now Skeletor and Hoplite are just going to die fast. It to so vital for the Paragon troops that they'll get this charge. And now, yeah, overextending the Hippias Lancers, the Bakshan of course are going to destroy them together with the Tour Spears. Nice beautiful charge from the Hippias Lancers, but now they need to retreat. The infantry will come in. And yeah, Pergamon is just overwhelming Bakshia right now. Because Bakshia does not stop the charges of the Hippias Lancers. And let's see, yeah, the Bakshian of course are dying. Everything is dying for Bakshian right now. But nice flanking over here. The Galatian Spears are going to try to stop it. And Torque Swords are going to engage them. This is going to be easy win for the Torque Swords. Nice recharge from the Skeletorx shop there, but Hippias are just going to charge there. The Galatians are going to recharge here. The Hippias are dying, but Galatian Swords came. A Demon Spears are shooting. Don't think this is necessarily a bad idea, because there are more horses, more in the Bakshian of Horse than Hippias Lancers. So they can actually hit the Bakshian of Horse, but it's still not a great idea. Big Peltas will probably, yeah, they'll just destroy this Bakshian Roguard. But Bakshian of Horse are incoming, and this huge threat to the Skirmishers. Let's see over here. Skeletorx Hoplite getting wrecked by Galatian Swords, of course. The Torox Swords are winning here, but here they got absolutely wrecked. The general got too overextended. And let's see here. The Bakshian of course died, and this unit is free to recharge here. And this is over. Yep. General getting recharged. Now Galatian Swords are going to come in. Even two Hippias Lancers. Actually, three Hippias Lancers are alive. No, what? All the Hippias Lancers are still in the field. Yeah, this was not very close. And Galatian Swords, so good performance from them. The Hope Test as well. But the real killer for Pergamon was the Hippias Lancers. And Big Peltas, look at these kills, very nice. The Geon Spears, nice kills. And for Bakshia, yeah, two Bakshian of course got wrecked, two did well. The Eastern Singers, they just didn't have the chance to kite Pergamon and to shoot at anything besides the crappy Singers. The Skeletorx Hoplite got wrecked by Hippias Lancers. Torox Swords did crap, the Torox Spear did crap, these guys did well. Thing is, if the Marvelist blocked the cavalry charge from Mary Kong, it should be easy win, because the Torox Swords would just grind it out against the low tier Galatian Swords and Galatian Spears. The Hoplite could be helpful, but Torx Swords are just better, and Bakshian of course are real tank units. But well played to both players, and good luck to Eric Wong. I think he's playing Sofado, and then the winner will play against me in the semifinals. So good luck to both of them, and see you in the next video.